Samsung produced Galaxy S24 in two different variants. USA, Canada, and China got the Snapdragon, while the rest of us got the Exynos. Today, I will compare the battery life and efficiency of these two phones. I've already done this test before, and the Snapdragon was ahead by 17% in terms of battery life. But there are several reasons that I decided to do this test again. First, in the last test, I didn't test the light performance mode, as a lot of you already requested. Second, by the end of February, Samsung released a major update for both phones. Third, this time I actually wrote an Android application that precisely measures the power consumption, CPU usage, and battery life and the temperature of the phone all the time during the test, and this way we can more precisely compare the phone to each other. For testing conditions, I'm testing at a room temperature of around 24 degrees Celsius, which is 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Both phones are charged to 100%, and both of them are always connected to the same Wi-Fi network and the same carrier, which is A1. In previous videos, some people mentioned the signal of the S24 Exynos is weaker than the S24 Snapdragon. But at least on my desk, I measured the signals with multiple tools, and in all of them, they had similar strength. They are also connected to the same band, so everything is identical. I measured the brightness of both phones to the same level using a lux meter. Let's briefly talk about the app that I wrote and what it does. The app simply shows five things on top: the temperature of the battery in Celsius, the battery percentage, the signal strength, the CPU utilization, and the power drawn from the battery. We want the power drawn and temperature to be lower. The app also logs all the information in file. I wrote some Python script, and I will use them later in Python to draw some fancy charts. Also, thanks again to everyone in the community post that helped me make the app better with your suggestions. If you want to be part of the community, please don't forget to subscribe to get the community post. The test will have four stages. On each stage, I will run a test that will consist of around 25 minutes of 4K YouTube video streaming, then 10 minutes of photography with continuous shutter, followed by 15 minutes of Google Meets. In the first stage, both phones are connected to Wi-Fi and the light performance profile. To activate this profile, you can go to Setting. Under the performance profile, you will find light performance. So as I said, I ran this test, 4K YouTube videos, 10 minutes of photography, and Google Meets. During 4K video streaming, Exynos got slightly warmer, maybe around half a degree, and uses slightly more power, but nothing alarming. By the end of the test, Exynos used 1% more battery and it was 1.7 degrees Celsius or 3 degrees Fahrenheit hotter. Now, let's go to two charts for a deep dive. I know showing charts can be confusing, but I will really try my best to break them down for you. The first chart shows power consumption over time using a unit called watts. On the x-axis, you have time, and the y-axis, you have power consumption. The red dots belong to Exynos, and the blue dots belong to Snapdragon. The average power used by Exynos during the first stage is 17% more. Also, if you notice, the red dots are always higher than the blue dots, which means Exynos continuously uses more battery in all tasks. Especially the difference is visible on the camera test and Google Meets test. The second chart shows the changes in temperature over time. Again, the red dots belong to Exynos and the blues belong to Snapdragon. As you can see, the Exynos variant temperature is continuously higher than the Snapdragon. Now let's move to the second stage. I turned off the light mode and now we are testing on Wi-Fi and a standard performance mode. The behavior that both phones showed in the standard performance were very similar, if not identical, to the behavior on the right performance. Exynos got to around 40 degrees Celsius, which is 104 Fahrenheit. By the end of the test, Exynos had 79% battery left, while the Snapdragon had 82% left. Again, the power usage and temperature were very similar to the light performance mode. But a disclaimer, I was not super careful about making sure I was doing the exact thing on both light and standard performance. For example, I may have run YouTube a bit longer in one of them than the other. Nevertheless, I tried hard to find some correlation or pattern to find out if light performance has an effect on battery life, and I could not find one, at least in these tests. It seems like the light mode does two things. First, it reduces the maximum frequency of the CPU. The second, it throttles the CPU at a lower temperature. For example, in light performance mode, the max CPU utilization was at 92%, while in standard performance, it was 100%. But that was only a few seconds in which the CPU had to actually work to 100%. In 99.9% of the situation, you don't need the max CPU utilization. So I would say it doesn't really hurt to put your phone on a light performance mode. Maybe there are some situations that increases the battery life and the whole situation regarding temperature and thermals. For the third stage, I did the same test, but this time on power saving mode. This mode does a few things. First, it sets the refresh rate of the screen to 60 frames per second max. It also reduces the CPU clock max to 70%. Again, I could not find any meaningful difference in power consumption in this mode either. In retrospect, I didn't choose the best set of tests for testing power saving mode. The most important part of this mode is to reduce the refresh rate to 60Hz, and the phone is already LTOP, which means the refresh rate is adaptive. I did try to run 5G tests next, but in the middle of it, I realized I set both phones on HD for YouTube, so I stopped the test, and since I was really curious about the difference between the two modes, I ran some CPU throttle tests. It seems the max clock rate is lower on light performance mode, and simultaneously, the phone throttles at lower temperature, which is not a bad thing. This will ensure your phone does not overheat, which is in turn will damage the battery life long term. I left both phones connected to Wi-Fi overnight. Galaxy S24 Exynos used exactly 2% more battery compared to S24 Snapdragon. Snapdragon used 7% in 9 hours and Exynos used 9%. Then I put both phones on my backpack and I went to work. They both connected to 5G the whole time. This standby test was around 6 hours in which I was 2 hours on the train rides going to Lower Austria, as you can see in the map. Snapdragon used 6% and Exynos used 8%, but frankly, both of them did a great job and passed the standby test. On my way home, I took some pictures to check if Exynos fixed the white balance in the updates. But unfortunately, that was not the case. I took a picture of the same blue chair as last time, and Exynos captured it as white. When I got home, I did the last part of the test, which was running the phone on 5G. So far, Exynos is 11% behind. On 5G, Exynos unfortunately did not handle it well. Only after 15 minutes of Google Meets, the signal was dropping and the phone got to 46 degrees Celsius, which is 113 Fahrenheit. Granted, the phone temperature started at around 40 Celsius and 104 Fahrenheit, but simultaneously, this is not an unusual temperature. Basically, it means if you are in your car or on a train in summer, you pretty much should forget having a video call or having a meeting. If you look at the charts, you notice something interesting. Exynos this time used 27% more power compared to a Snapdragon. Not only that, but it also increased the temperature much more compared to Wi-Fi tests. This shows that on Wi-Fi, the Exynos variant is less efficient, but connected to 5G, it is even worse. At the end of the 5G test, I ran some 4K videos to drain the Exynos battery to zero. Snapdragon finished the test with 18% more battery, which at this point is not surprising anymore, hence I won't play some dramatic music. Let's take a look at the final charts. As you can see, the 5G test at the end used the most amount of power. In total, the Exynos variant was around 17% less efficient in normal Wi-Fi tests, and 27% during the 5G test. The battery temperature on average is also a couple of degrees higher. On the standby test, the Exynos variant was 30% less efficient. So I should answer the main question. Do you actually notice this on day-to-day life? And the answer is yes, you do. That was easy to answer. But I can also like put it in two perspectives. One is performance. Is Snapdragon snappier and faster than Exynos? Actually, that's not what I experienced when I was using both phones. Both of them are really great, they're really snappy and really fast. At the same time, I did notice that Snapdragon battery is much better than the Exynos. On the Exynos defense, it is not a phone that is worse than S23 in terms of battery life, but it's also not better. A lot of people say Exynos this year is much better than Exynos in the S22 and previous generations. My theory is that Exynos chipset didn't really had a great jump or great improvement. What happened is that Samsung just figured out how to make a better vapor chamber and how to make a better cooling system. But still, Exynos unfortunately is not a super efficient chipset. If you like this video, you're also gonna like the one that is popping up on the screen right now. Thanks for tuning in to Techmo. Until the next one, bye!